Our story began at the Astral Academy, the highest place of wizardly learning in all the kingdom. The Academy housed magical secrets in its vaults, and the wizards had vowed to protect them from falling into the wrong hands. A fiercely persistent monster had set its mind upon penetrating the front gates.
Oh, how odd. The monster is immune to our magic.
With all these recent incidents around the Academy, I'm beginning to think we need outside assistance.
I will be free.
Let's send for help. What we need is our heroes.
With trouble in the kingdom, who could save the day? Why, of course, the three heroes of our story, Amadeus, Pontius, and Zoya. Once upon a time, they had all lived ordinary, unremarkable lives. Fates of kingdoms hadn't hung in balance because of their actions. Not until a fateful meeting had changed their lives forever. When they had discovered Trine, the artifact of soul. At that time, Pontius, a stout-hearted knight and protector of the common folk, was busy at work. He was tracking a thief who had abducted a sheep from a poor peasant family.
The no-good bandit is hiding somewhere in these ravines. I'll catch him and save that sheep, or my name isn't Pontius the Brave.
I don't know what it is, but the world looks more vivid than usual this morning. Bandit must be lurking nearby.
Hey!
Release the sheep, and I'll let you go.
Oh, but there you,
thieving blackguard. He won't be getting away. We go. I know how to throw my weight around. There's that blasted thief! That poor sheep is about to end up as goblin grub if I don't do something. Your fork and dinner knife. This sheep is going back home with me.
Yeah!
That's the end of them. Let's set you free.
While Pontius was the strongest and bravest of them all, Zoya was another matter entirely. Zoya relied on her bow and her grappling hook to keep her distance from any trouble. She was brave in her way, but perhaps in a manner that was more self-serving than honorable. Zoya had been a thief long before circumstances had made her a reluctant hero. In the recent years, though, Zoya had less interested in burgling the largesse of high society. Instead, she directed her attentions abroad, to far distant lands and their old forgotten ruins and treasures.
My prize at last. I usually like animals, but I could make an exception with this parrot.
Hey!
I take my rope out. Well, finally. What was that?
The last of our three heroes was Amadeus. As a young man, he dreamed of becoming a powerful sorcerer in order to impress people, but he never really got the knack for the grand fireballs he dreamt of. Amadeus was only ever good for conjuring boxes. Thankfully, it had turned out to be a skill more useful than he'd ever expected. Amadeus the wizard was enjoying a well-deserved holiday to see migrating giant turtles with his wife Margaret and their three children. The wizard's wife was a firebrand of a woman, and all their three children were very talented when it came to conjuring fireballs. In fact, it was a small blessing that one afternoon they had left poor Amadeus to have a nap in peace. But he slept too long. When he woke up, he was already late to see the great turtles.
I'm late. Oh, I'm so late.
Let's see if they went this way. Maybe, if I climb up on the cliffs, I could have a better view of the beach. I might find the turtles as well as Margaret and the children.
Thank you. This skull gate is securely locked, but I want to get in. Magnificent view.
And there are the turtles, on their way to make more turtles, I suppose. The artifact of soul. How nice of you to join me. Thank you again for all the magic powers you bestowed on me, and all the marvelous adventures. If you're here about business, I'm sorry, but I'm unable to join you. You see, this is the first time I've ever been on holiday with my family since you and I first met. Please?
Oh, it's Trine. Can you wait a little? I still need to return this sheep to its family.
Oh, your timing is extremely inconvenient. Well, right.
It was not unusual that our three heroes would be whisked away at a moment's notice, for with great power came also great responsibility. The artifact of soul had arcane powers of resurrection, making our three heroes immortal and capable of great deeds and adventures. Sometimes, whether the heroes wanted these adventures or not.
I still don't understand how this Trine magic works.
It's a bit tiresome to put all your life on hold because of a magical candle stand with a flair for abducting bystanders for adventures.
I was in the middle of a daring rescue myself.
We seem to be at the outskirts of the Astral Academy.
This isn't a good place for an adventure. I've already pinched everything.
Huh?
Twin gates blocked the hero's path. But how would they handle the handles?
Sink or swim. The Astral Academy go through a lily pond.
Landscaping isn't really a part of the curriculum.
Huh?
Troublemaker!
Defeated monster, soon scattering and fading into the wind.
Smokes of vile sorceries!
Look here! This villain, it's made of junk.
Creepy. How's this for an idea? If we all give Trine back its powers, we could go back to living our lives as free and normal people.
Freedom. It does sound tempting.
The heroes had gained their strange powers in the first place by touching the artifact, and so they reached out to it again.
I don't think it's working.
Imagine giving away your powers.
How about I imagine sticking an arrow through this busy...
No!
Turned out worse than I could have imagined.
It's headed for the academy.
All right, that makes it a little worse, and I guess that means...
We're going to follow it! What's this?
Magic. It's taking possession of the roots.
Let's see if they fall as easily as the big one.
was a bit surprised to hear Zoya scream when the artifact broke.
Wait, what? You must be talking about Amadeus.
I made no such sound.
Well, if neither of you screamed, who was it?
So many days spent fishing, and nothing to show for it. What bad luck. There will be fish stew for dinner.
altered landscaping?
I'm sure they had something practical in mind when they set these up.
Pontius, you went along with us in trying to return things back to normal. But I don't get it. Why would Pontius the Brave voluntarily give up his magic powers?
I've been starting to think Trine is a little unfair when it comes to prioritizing our adventures between the socio-economic classes.
Huh? What?
We're always rescuing kings and princesses. What about the sheep?
Thank you. Thank you.
It looks like this tiny shard of Trine gives us some of our old power.
Keep it safe, Amadeus. I've a hunch we're going to need it when we track down that dark cloud.
Onwards!